Welcome to CNN Business Traveler. I'm Richard Quest. This month, reporting from Las Vegas, a city of opportunity, chance, and of course, risk. How very similar to when we buy our airline tickets. Think about it. It's like rolling the dice, spinning the roulette wheel. You can never be quite sure what price you're going to pay. There are ways to increase the odds of a better bargain, like bidding in a live auction for a first-class seat.
So now I'm the top of the leaderboard.
Learning when to pay with those loyalty points to avoid a premium price.
You have status, I have nothing, but we're still sitting next to each other.
You said that with real joy.
Even gaming the system.
Look at that, it's telling me you should book now.
There are good deals and gimmicks vying for your attention. And that's why Las Vegas is the perfect place as we explore the price of flying. The most perishable commodity in the world at the moment is on this plane. An empty airline seat. Once those wheels lift off the ground, that empty seat can no longer be sold. Which is why setting airfares is a tricky business. It's been called the dark arts. For passengers like you and me, it's a mysterious process happening in the shadows. Ticket prices changing by the day, by the hour, sometimes by the minute. The wizardry behind it all, complex mathematical algorithms, driving the price changes, always calculating a traveller's next move.
It's rocket science.
He's not kidding. Andy Boyd was the chief scientist at a company that supplies revenue management systems to major airlines around the world. Revenue management, or RevMan, is the constant tinkering of airfares, which has you paying top dollar for that coach seat, while your next door neighbor got a bargain.
And revenue management is really fundamentally about looking at what the market's willing to pay.
Airlines have decades of data on passengers' flying habits and buying behavior. It enables them to predict demand on any given flight.
The computers do the work by themselves. Estimate what passengers you expect to show up, use that in an algorithmic mix to figure out how you're going to set the different prices.
You do a price check in the morning and it's X. By the afternoon, it's X plus Y. And you're thinking, why didn't I buy yesterday? It's infuriating.
It is, and I get infuriated when it happens to me too.
Those different prices, or fare classes, are known in the industry as buckets. So here's how revenue management works.
Think of these balls as being the various seats on a particular plane, and the buckets are the different fare classes. This is the most expensive seat on the plane. Now, the airline knows it's not going to sell everything out of here.
It redistributes some of those seats to some of the lower fare buckets.
Right, and what's the difference between these various buckets?
Change fees, you have to pay to get your bag on the plane.
As the airline is selling seats, the buckets close.
Without just selling them out, it can just choose to close them and put them in the higher fare bucket.
So you literally just close out the buckets.
Yes. Oh, wait, now the demand has slowed down. We need to move some back down into the lower fare buckets again. Oh, too many people are showing up. You close down some of those buckets again. Close them down. You need to get them back up here. Oh, yes, and make sure you get some all the way up here because you don't want them in there. It's typically taking place all of the time. I do have to say it's a lot easier with a computer.
I would say that this is the fundamental competitive advantage that an airline can build.
Sebastian Mikosch knows the importance of perfect pricing. He's the former chief executive of LOT Polish Airlines and now the chief executive of eSky, an online travel agency.
Is there an occasion when you, as an airline, you would rather have let the seat go empty than discount it?
This is the holy grail you're talking about. It's much better for an airline to let an empty seat fly than to discount it.
Airlines can't afford to have passengers suddenly changing their buying behavior. If they do, it'll destroy the pricing model.
Basically, the revenue management and the whole complicated universe of prices is very much based on the prediction of how customers are going to behave.
We have seen how airlines use science and art to price the tickets. Now they want to raise even more money by auctioning off the upgrades. In true Las Vegas fashion, they're turning to gambling and inviting passengers to bid for the better seats.
The lure of the big win. In Vegas, the opportunities are all around. They're hard to resist. Kevin Stamler is the CEO of Seat Boost. He hopes his idea is just as attractive. He's found a way to liven up that idle time waiting to board, sitting at the gate. Seat Boost teamed up with Virgin America and now auctions off any free available premium seats on certain routes, minutes before the doors close.
I have thousands of pictures and videos of people smiling, fist pumping, looking at their phones.
Stamler came up with the idea as he watched passengers turning down upgrades while checking in. Getting an airline to buy into his idea took some convincing.
You have to deal with the revenue management people.
That's right.
That basically said, we cannot let people expect that they're going to be able to buy in the auction. Otherwise, they'll never buy before the auction.
We are more positioned for a flyer or a guest who wants to give themselves a treat. If you are used to flying first class, you're not going to leave it to chance.
Upgrade auctions are nothing new. PlusGrade and Option Town also auction better seats. But their auctions start and finish days before the flight. Seat Boost's originality is the bidding begins 90 minutes before takeoff.
So there's four seats, say, available.
Sure.
If you're the top bid,
yes,
and you've paid more in the auction than the person who gets the third seat, you'll be thinking, I shouldn't have bid so much.
Maybe, but how secure do you want to feel in your desired upgrade?
Unless you're sitting next to the person that got the upgrade for less than you did.
But what's wrong with that?
It's like sitting next to anybody on a plane who's paid less for their seat.
Let me tell you something.
You feel.
The degree to which people are happy when they win or when they're just playing has been spectacular.
So rough and ready, the best way to show how Seat Boost works is actually have a go. Right, what are we bidding on?
So we're bidding on a first class seat to LAX from SFO, and I'm gonna show you how this works. You only pay for anything if you win the upgrade. Everything else is free. Here you are in the auction.
So Carmela has bid $19, so I've got to go. 29, right, so now I'm the top of the leaderboard.
Now you're the top, right? But here comes me, and now my paddle will show 24, and now I'm gonna beat you.
Hang on, the producer's gone to 34.
Oh, well, she's a secret assassin.
Let's just blow you out of the water.
And so you see your name kind of climb up and down.
So if I put another $4 on there, I think we've won this one.
There's 30 seconds left. Only the top five people on the leaderboard would be allowed to enter the final round. You get one final bid, we'll see who won. Nope, you lost, I lost. Oh, here she is. Carmela with the winner.
You have bid a silly amount. I made a sensible, rational bid.
Yes.
We are impressed by the way you played.
So in the bright lights of Vegas, we've sized up our opponents and tried to outplay them. But this wouldn't be a gambling town if we didn't try to get something for nothing. And that's next.